Hey guys, Scara9 here, welcome back to my channel today, and in this video we are going to be going over a ton of stuff coming with Season 4. We have some information about the Gambit ranking system and the rewards that will come from this amazing new game mode, the changes to the competitive rank, as well as a brand new weapon that they are adding into the game that is probably going to be the most controversial weapon in the history of Destiny. So let's just go ahead and get into it. So the first thing I do want to start off by talking about is the Gambit ranking systems and rewards. So this has a brand new ranking system called Infamy. It essentially is just a reskinned Valor rank. Winning matches in succession gives you more points, but losing does not take them away. It just does not give you as many points. In addition, we learned that it is going to follow the very same tier structure as the Valor, you know, from Guardian to Legend. Pretty much the same thing. However, in Gambit, with the Infamy ranks, each rank is going to be divided into three subsections just to make earning rewards a little bit more consistent. In addition, there are Gambit bounties that you can complete each day that will grant rank points, plus a weekly bounty that will reward a large increase of infamy and a piece of powerful gear. And it also appears that Gambit will have its own set of armor, some pieces of which will be purchasable on a weekly basis based on your rank, and its own set of weapons, once again, that you can purchase once you hit a certain rank if it is available from the vendor on that week. And then also remember, the Malfeasance exotic hand cannon will also be tied into Infamy rank and Gambit in some way. So all around, I am loving the Infamy system. I love how they're making it more Valor-based and not Glory-based. This is going to help make Gambit something that is more focused on being just extreme amounts of fun and super rewarding. So I cannot wait to get into that and start ranking up my Infamy. Now, the next thing I do want to talk about are the changes to the Glory or competitive rank changes going into Season 4. So Glory rank points gained and lost have been retuned to reduce the overall climb to higher ranks, meaning you will get more points for winning and you will lose less points for losing, essentially just making your time a little bit more worthwhile in competitive Crucible. In addition, the radar is coming back to competitive gameplay, which is something I'm not too happy about, but it's not the worst change in the world. The control and clash modes have both been added to the competitive playlist. The loss streaks have been removed, which will be a huge benefit when you are matched against the same team that is kicking your ass over and over again. And then the pinnacle Crucible rewards are now awarded via quests, things like the Lunas Howl that we have seen in the gameplay, essentially this Season 4 version of the Rageless Claymore. These types of things will be awarded via quests instead of just hitting Fabled rank. Now, one thing that I did mention at the beginning of the video is the addition of a very controversial weapon, and this is going to be called Rajrix's Broadsword. Now, we don't have the most information of this in the world. There's a ton of stuff that we don't know yet, but I'm going to read it directly from the bullet points from the This Week at Bungie, and I'm going to let you guys make your own decisions until we actually know the full information. Lord Shax will offer a new quest that players can complete to earn Rajrix's Broadsword, a companion weapon to Rajrix's Claymore. It says that Rajrix's Broadsword will feature a similar talent arrangement, but it does not share the lore and triumphs associated with the Claymore. Once you have earned the weapon, random roll versions of the Broadsword will start dropping from Crucible Engrams. Each drop will have a fixed Outlaw and Desperado combination. Each drop will also have randomized barrels, magazines, and masterwork perks. Players who earned Rajrix's Claymore in Season 3 will still receive additional bonuses, like an exclusive emblem when you redeem the corresponding triumph, and Claymore owners will be eligible for drops of the Broadsword from Crucible Engrams even without completing the quest. So this means on day one, if you have the Rajrix's Claymore, you can load into Shax and buy the Broadsword directly from him and try to get those really good random rolls. So where do I land on this? It essentially looks like they're adding a knockoff version of the Claymore that is in fact better because it has random rolls, and all you have to do to get it is complete a quest. Now, they did not talk about the difficulty of this quest. They did not talk about if the Broadsword is an energy weapon. They did not confirm if the Broadsword was even a pulse rifle, to my knowledge. So there's a whole bunch of stuff that we don't know here. They do refer to it as a companion weapon to the Claymore. If it is an energy weapon, can you run the Claymore in your kinetic slot and the Broadsword in your energy slot, and they have some type of synergy? Is the Broadsword, like I said, even a pulse rifle? Is it essentially just a better version of the Claymore, but you don't get the ornament for hitting maximum rank, and it just has a different name? What is going on here? I really wish they would have given us more information. However, I will say, if it is just the Rajrix's Claymore, this quest better be very difficult. Everyone who has the Rajrix's Claymore played very, very, very hard to get it, especially if you got it within the original changes before they made it even easier to get with the Glory rank system changes late in the season. So if the quest is a walk in the park and 90% of the population is walking around with the Radrix's broadsword, I will not be very happy. However, if it is a very lengthy quest, it still requires you to hit Fabled in Glory, because that is much, much easier now. And then in addition to that, you have to do some other things. I'll be a little bit more happy about it. I do hope it's not just a reprint of the Claymore. I hope it has its own perks and it does have some type of synergy or something, but we will just have to wait and see. Now, the final thing I do want to talk about in this video are changes to the clan system. They are now adding daily and weekly bounties to complete to increase your clan's level, so you won't just increase your clan's level by doing like nightfalls anymore with clanmates. You will actually have to do like daily and weekly bounties, which is interesting. And then in addition to that, they are making the clan banner bonuses much more impactful. They gave three examples. So the rank 3 for season 4 is increased resilience when you are in a fire team with clanmates. Rank 5 grants a chance to receive additional etheric and baryon resources while collecting them in the which are of course going to be the location resources for the Tangled Shore and the Dreaming City. And then rank 6 makes it so that the weekly clan milestone also grants a masterwork core. But other than that, we don't know much about what is going on with the system. I'm excited that they're making it more impactful. You actually have to strive to increase your clan level and it will actually have a meaningful impact. But we'll just have to wait and see what the full extent of this is. And then just a little tidbit, they did show us one of the new exotic emotes coming next season. It is this weird hologram swing emote. I don't know why you would use this, but they did show it, so I thought I'd let you guys know. So I've let you guys know what I think about all of this stuff. Now it is your turn. Let me know what you're thinking about all of these things down in the comment section below. Do you like it? Do you hate it? Are you excited for the Radrix's broadsword? Do you think it's kind of crappy? Let me know down in that comment section below. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like rating and a share it with your friends. If you were interested in watching either of the two videos on screen, you can click their respective annotations to be taken to them. If you're brand new to my channel, make sure to hit the giant version of my logo on screen to be subscribed to my awesome Destiny 2 videos and live streams. Thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you in my next video.